could you comment on left liberal bloggers or the other ways whom you call as Savarna bloggers?
I generally call them Hindutva blogs, because all the discourse on the internet is dominated by Hindutva discourse. In a way, you are either pro Sangha elements or are you anti Sangha elements. There is nothing beyond that. And most of the participants are also come from a certain social equation, which is usually the so-called Savarna classes or the Brahminist classes, as they call them, you know, which includes the upper Shudras and also sections of the upper OBCs. So this discourse is generally dominated by these sections. We also had mentioned recently, 85% of Indian internet is dominated by the so-called internet Hindus. So the internet Hindus by themselves doesn't mean they are all Sanghis. It also means people who legitimize the issues raised by Sanghis by discussing only those issues. Like earlier we had discussed that, you know, why doesn't caste happen to be such a big issue on the internet or in the media or in any public space which is, you know, generally referred to as civil society. So this is one of the reasons, you know, the dominant classes who see themselves as Hindu or liberal or secular are generally from the same Savarna location, and by privileging only issues which concern their idea of nation and secularism and also democracy and civil society, they generally reinforce the notion that, you know, all the discourse on internet generally and in media generally revolves around a certain kind of Hindutva, whether it's, you know, the venomous Hindutva propagated by the Sangha elements or the, let's say, the soft in the Hindutva propagated by the left liberal elements. So they have a large presence, you know. The Hindutva and pro Hindutva elements have certain blog sites which, you know, virtually, you know, have hundreds of groupies, hundreds and thousands of groupies, and they call themselves, patterning themselves after the American national interest, they call themselves the Indian national interest, and they have lots of think tanks. They also have what are called lobbyist groups, and they also have international connections. There are American Hindus, there are Canadian Hindus, there are Hindus from UK, all these groups are also, you know, largely connected, and the issues they raise don't really catch the attention of the Dalit Balbhojan, you know, minority bloggers, because they don't seem to, you know, actually touch upon any things that concern their daily lives or their social or economic existence. They concern mostly the left liberal bodies. The issues raised by the left liberal and also the Hindu, so-called Hindutva bloggers, are the same issues but different viewpoints. So the privileging of a certain discourse itself, the whole discourse happening, is of a, you know, very narrow kind. So these left liberal bloggers I generally refer to as Hindutva bloggers also, because they don't deviate from the issues raised by the pro Hindutva bloggers, the supposedly formally pro Hindutva bloggers. So when someone rises an issue of let's say terrorism, they usually debate the rights of certain Muslim groups or the violence of the security or the appeasement of certain Muslim groups, or the so-called terror networks among Muslims. And these are the issues both of these sections debate consistently. And they don't see the question of terror as being going beyond merely the religious divide, as going beyond merely a certain kind of sections of people. It involves the whole of Indian civil society and state, and it involves every village, and it involves primarily the institutions of caste. Terror emanates primarily from caste in India. You can see that in the malnutrition rates among Dalits and Adivasis. You can see it in the starvation rates among them. You can see it in the landlessness of the Dalits, and you can see it among their general lack of livelihoods. I mean, 50% of them are unemployed laborers. If we are talking about that kind of terror, we ignore that kind of terror, and we generally raise issues of very dramatic kinds of terror as carried out by certain disgruntled Muslim groups or Hindu groups. It's mostly Hindu groups. The funny thing is, even before the bombing of the Makkah Masjid event had totally unfolded, even before the people had come to realize what actually had happened there, the television screens were screaming about Indian Mujahideen and other people, other groups. We don't really know whether there is such a thing as Indian Mujahideen, but as it eventually turned out, it was part of the Sangh Parivar itself, which had taken up the bombing of the masjid. And whatever point of view is expressed by those calling themselves left liberals, or those calling themselves Hindu nationalists on Indian internet, they're basically all Savarna Hindu nationalists. So we can't really say one group, only one group is Hindutva oriented and the other is not. That is, that is not a complete definition of what they are. They are basically people concerned with the issues which concern Hindus, which is the Savarna Hindus, and not the rest of the population of India, which is generally all kinds of minorities. Their reactions not just on this issue, on the issue of Ambedkar cartoon, the left liberals, I mean, you are referring to them as left liberals, I call them Samanna bloggers or Hindutva bloggers. So their reactions were quite similar on both the cartoon issue and on the Lokpal issue. Among the left liberals and among the Hindutvavadis also, there were certain sections who were quite comfortable with Anna Hazare, and who were also very offended by the removal of the cartoon. And among the left liberals also, there were some people who were listening to the Dalits, but they were not actually listening. They were not totally listening to the Dalits. They were not listening to the other voices which are opposing the cartoon. So what we can really say is that, despite their so-called, politics that they profess, that they say they profess, we can't really take away the 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 doubts we have about what politics are they talking from, what vantage point of politics, what location of politics are they talking from. I mean, because we see only their social location. General disapproval of all kinds of Dalit or Bahujan articulation, all kinds of suspicion of Dalit or Bahujan articulation, all kinds of dehumanizing or rising in doubts about Dalit or Bahujan articulation. We can't really say that they are talking from a standard left liberal point of view. All we see is their location, 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 location. Apart from that location, what do we see? Have we seen anyone really truly pay attention to what Anup was saying or what Savari was saying, what Rajkumar was saying? They were patronizingly or totally dismissed as raising certain important issues or being generally rhetorical. So we had to realize that what we face is not a politics but a certain location which is generating this politics.